this the place where love lives? I swam from the stream, just kept trying to breathe. It's hard to believe I feel so safe in the sea.
A somber song, but a beautiful song. The kids wrote it 10 years ago, something like that. I still think it's going to be a big hit. I'm thinking of doing a real major league what do you call it, computer orchestration of it. And you can sound, those things can sound pretty good, especially if you make them sound like a little human. Don't make everybody perfect. Listen, what did you guys do with my coffee? Where's my coffee? Where'd it go? I'm not going any further until I find it. Just a second. Talk amongst yourselves, and I'm sure you will. You know. Yeah. I know it's late at night, but I go to sleep right away. It doesn't matter. I get tired. I'm asleep. I go to sleep. Everybody all right today? I worked so hard for this, I'm going to have some. Well, yeah, I don't really drink so much of it. I get a cup and I have a sip and I throw it away. But I got these new drip coffees, small ones. They make about 5 cups. But I always been buying new coffees just to see what they taste like. And I make 4 cups, pour one, drink a half of it, and throw the rest away. Prevagen. What's Prevagen? I know what Prevagen is. Coffee is very important. It's our antidepressant for most people. Certainly is for me. What's that? What's that back there? It's a violin. Wonder if anybody plays it. I'll go back and take a look. Oh, it's a cane. It's a cane to walk back to the violin with. Uh-oh. This is not good. Another microphone. Because I don't have the proper thing for this microphone, I still refuse to get it. I keep thinking I'm bound to have one around here. The exact proper fit. So the microphone, this microphone's been through hell. I've dropped it 57 times as a result of all this. But it just keeps on ticking. I'm putting my phone on silent, which means I'll never hear it again. I'll never remember to turn it back. I practiced a song today. I practiced today. I hate to admit it. I'm reading the wrong thing. Damn. G treble clef. G E flat. I see. Let me get this out of the way here. I don't think of G, E flat in the treble clef as being here. You know, like in 13th position, whatever this is. I'll accept it here, but here, I don't know. No, no, I was telling my wife that I knew Thad. A lot of us knew Thad. I'm sure Bill knew Thad very well. But I got to work with him a little bit and loved him. He was a wonderful guy. And the thing I realized about the band tonight, the morale in that band was very high. They had a lot of fun on that band. That's the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Band. Okay. Let's see what's around the corner here. Hamish. Oh, look at this. No one to talk to, all by myself. No one to walk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. I'm ain't misbehaving. I'm saving my love for you. I think it would have changed the key to C. I know for certain the one I love. I'm through with her, and it's just you that I'm thinking of. Ain't misbehaving. Saving my love for you. Like Jack Horner in a corner. Do da do da do da do da do 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 do. I don't stay out late, I don't care to go. I'm home about 8, just me and my radio. A-list raving, I'm saving all my love for you. Saving all my love for you. Song. Let me write the key down. D flat is a good key for that for me. It gets you out of those easy keys and get you playing the bass a little bit. G flat. I'll never remember it. I shan't remember to write it down this evening. And I don't have a pencil here. No. Don't keep a pencil on a music stand. That would never do. My gracious. I have 150,000 pencils. I can see them over there, but I don't have them anywhere near me. Gotta remember, Ain't Misbehaving in D flat. I like that. I like it. It's a nice, I like the lyric too. It's not some kind of lyric that makes me cringe. You know. And I'm going to belt you in the mouth because I love you so. No, I don't like, that's not my idea of a good lyric. See, I don't know, maybe I'm old-fashioned. I don't think this book's going to hold it. Let's go to here and go. Back in Italy of old, when men were brave and bold, and Columbus had just sailed across the seas, the ladies from Verona and gentlemen from Bologna would place lutes and mandolins across their knees. They had lots of lutes and lyres, they didn't use amplifiers. It was a civil age. Violins and cellos were made by thieves and fellows and composers like Vivaldi were the rage. The year was 1550 and orchestras were nifty and violinists dearly loved to bow notes. But the ladies and their fellows on their violins and cellos found they simply couldn't reach the low notes. So when Gasparo da Salo did his intuition follow and set out to build a giant violin, the concept was outrageous, but nonetheless contagious and so inspired. He did begin. I'm glad I'm practicing. He whittled and he glued, he boiled and he brewed. He varnished, chipped and chiseled, bent and treated. He worked with great endeavor and get discouraged never. one day he found the task completed. Yes, one day he was through and he brought it out to view. A violin like none had seen before. His tone was rich and deep, right down where the fishes sleep. And oh, the depth it added to the score. To the score. People looked at it in awe, and they wondered what they saw, and they thought poor Gasparo had lost his mind. The man cannot be serious, the man must be delirious. He started to unwind. Oh, Gasparo, face the facts, no one's going to play that axe. It's too clumsy, it's too big, it's too clumsy, it's too large. You're gonna need a barge to get it to a gig. While its sound may be profound, just to lug the thing around, it's got to be a nightmare in logistics. And the only willing players, the only willing players, oh my God. But the lug the thing, this sounds quite profound, but to lug the thing around, it's got to be a nightmare in logistics. The only willing players will be drunken dragon slayers, gladiators, flagellators, and sadistics. Then the local. Oh boy, I changed it to a swing and now I can't remember how it goes. Now while the sound is quite profound, lug the thing around, it's got to be a nightmare in logistics. The only willing players will be drunken dragon slayers, gladiators, flagellators, and sadistics. Gasparo was no faker, but a real fine. But Gasparo was no faker, but a real fine blind. Boy, when you're reading it, I've never read this song. I've always had it memorized. Now I'm reading it, and it's totally confusing me. I don't know what comes next. Da 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 da. Boom! So that I didn't realize that would happen. I didn't realize that could happen with a song. You know, when you start reading it, you start forgetting, because my hands were always telling me what's next. The lyric and the notes were always together. Well, the sound is quite profound, just to look at the around. It's got to be a nightmare in logistics. The only willing players will be drunken dragon slayers, gladiators, flagellators, and sadistics. Then a local folks started making up base jokes. Had to happen, don't you know? New jokes began to hatch like a buddy got a match. We should have taken up the piccolo. But Gasparo was no faker, but a real fine violin maker. He was no fraud or public menace, so he just kept on smiling as he watched his giant violin soon become the rage of Roman Venice. And here we are today, many centuries away. Gasparo's bass violin has made it through. You can pluck or you can bone notes, but you gotta have those low notes. And thanks to Gasparo, we do. Gasparo de Salo, here's to you. Gasparo de Salo, here's to you. Started making up bass jokes. It had happened, don't you know? New jokes began to hatch. I got it almost. Well, maybe I can screw up another one. My favorite songs are soup. That's nice. I like that one. Not going to sing it. Oops. Challenge of trying to make, just play the bass and sing the songs and make them as musically interesting and valid as possible. That takes practice, and I haven't been doing that. I'm noticing how a year off of really playing gigs now, a year. I mean, I've done a couple of recordings. I don't think I played two gigs and did two recordings in 1 year. And basically, I've just been playing the bass here in the house. And I'm noticing how my bass playing is getting a little sketchy now. It's getting sketchy. story about a man named Henry, a tale I know to be true, about a man going stale in a city jail, decided that his prison days were through. 5 years before Henry robbed a store, he got 10 to 20 years of no parole. One cold November night, Henry finally saw the light and decided that he'd dig himself a hole. Now Henry didn't have no shovel, had to steal himself a tablespoon. Started digging on the 3rd of November, stopped digging on the 3rd of June, cause it was 99 feet on thick concrete, moving slower than a snail. But every night while the warden slept tight, little Henry was escaping from jail. Every night, Henry stuffed up his bed so it looked like his head, and his body wasn't laying down at night. And when the guard checked his head, he knew damn well that was Henry in there sleeping tight. But every night he'd drop out of sight, down the hole and dug in the floor. It was under the bed and down through the tunnel to where he stopped the night before. Henry spooned out some dirt, then he wrapped it in his shirt, then he dragged it on back to his cell. A little by little, wash it on down the sink, and then he rested with everybody for his buckers. It was 99 feet on thick concrete, spooning and scratching away. Darker down there than an old coal mine, the never sun light up day. Finally, one summer morning, the papers had a story to tell about a modern prisoner named Henry, who was not to be found in his cell. Henry didn't show at mess that morning or at work that afternoon, and all they found was a 99-foot tunnel and an old tablespoon. The papers ran a picture that morning about the warden looking mighty pale. Seems he never figured on the day anybody dig his way out the Baltimore City jail, cause that was 99 feet thick concrete with nothing but a tablespoon. Cause it was 99 feet on the thick concrete, nothing but a tablespoon. Started digging on the 3rd of November, was a free man on the 3rd of June. Unfortunately, there's more to my story. Henry was like me and you. His tongue got to wagging and he got to bragging about what he'd done. Soon everybody knew. The warden's boys heard all of Henry's noise and they threw him on back in his cell. This time they gave him the penthouse apartment because I learned that lesson well. Henry finally made parole. He couldn't dig another hole in these days. He's finally free. But he left the legend and a tunnel behind him, and they're both as real as they could be, because it was 99 feet on the thick concrete, scrooging, scratching away. Hey, darker down there than an old coal mine, they never saw the light of 99 feet on the thick concrete, moving slower than a snail. But every night while the warden slept tight, little Henry was escaping. I did Henry was escaping. I did Henry was escaping from jail. Woo, woo, little Henry was escaping from jail. Do, do, do. Down there than an old coal mine, just A flat 7 and darker down. Well, it could have been like an F minus 7. Dark down there, darker down there. minor six with an A flat in the bass, or but an A flat seven I like even more. A flat do da dee da dee da. Just an A flat seven. Because it was 99 feet, C minor, D, 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 A flat 7, G 7, A flat 7, G 7. Yeah, I like it. It's impossible to sing and play the bass. I don't need to tell you that. you guys are great. You guys are great. Spooned Out. So funny story. That's the first real song I ever wrote. That got me on my way writing big, long story songs. The little short ones are the ones that make money. Like, hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Yeah, I do keep trying. Well, I do. I just don't practice enough. I don't work enough anymore. So this everything's getting rough around the edges in terms of consistency of when we're rehearsing every week. We're having a gig a week and rehearsing a week. Well, not never actually a gig a week, but sound is fine, but the video is dodgy. I've connected the sync twice now by reloading. Oh, I forgot the sync. Excuse me. You know, I'm always forgetting something, and I forgot to sync it. I'm sorry. Is this better? Is this better? Is this better? Maybe this is better. I'm sorry, that's the last thing I think about. Sync keeps going off, though. Oh, well, it should have, because... hey, Valerie, how are you? I didn't see the... how you feeling? Val, send me a tape of you and some of your friends, so I can use it constantly. Something that just belongs to me that I can use. It doesn't belong to me, it belongs to you, but that I can use just for fun. I need some private, just some private tapes. That's what I need. How can you forget the sink? Well, the bathtub. The bathtub is more important to me than the sink, frankly. I assume that you can hear me. I assume that this is high enough. Yes, yes. Darker down there than an old coal mine that never saw the light of day. Jason, we will be playing all the time for all kids of gigs like, yes, all kinds of gigs like Bermitsa. The sync goes off while you are playing, but refreshing the link straightens it out. Nothing you are doing. It's the ether. You're... Too much ether, Bill. Use less ether. Laughing gas. Don't worry. That's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sync. Sync a song. Thank you, Al, for straightening it out. It's either the ether or the other. Thank you. You guys are pretty good. Tomoko is high enough. Tomoko's a beauty. Look at this big, long list of comments. Yeah, my only problem with the comments is when I download them, I should really make a screenshot. I should make a screenshot of the show is what I should do. I should make a screenshot of the show every night. You know what I mean? Just put on the... I think I do have sufficient mileage to do that. So the comments come through real clear. Let me just try a little something here. Excuse me for a second. I'm guaranteed to have a good luck with this. I'm going to put QuickTime on. I'm going to do a screenshot, new screen recording. Doodle 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 doo. Oh, it's not doing it. Oh well, okay, record. Boom. Now I just want to see how much, because the show's, I'm actually recording the show now on the computer's recording it. Let's see how much it's using 18 gigs. I still have 11 to spare. I got things to spare. Okay, that's a good idea. I think from now on, I'm going to just record the show. That's it. I wish you could play it back for you. It's beautiful. That's my idea. Because what happens is the conversation, the chat, gets blurry. And I don't like that. So people reading it are going to have to struggle. They're not going to want to read it. So I'm going to... Now that I have the horsepower to do it, I'm going to make a recording of the show right on the computer. Because most recordings that I get will not capture the chat, and that's the best part of the show for me. Here's an anagram of ether. So what does that mean? So what does that matter? There's an anagram of ether. So what does that matter? Used to be so wise. I don't get that, and I don't know if I want to. Okay. Okay. You guys are doing fine. I don't really have much else to show you. I showed you that. Gone. Riverside Park, 90th Street. Did you like this one? Slow-mo on an iPhone. Whee! Face right in the snow. Fearless kid. Oh, yes. He does. You know, he's not here so I can say it, but he just, it's been a long year for him. Stuck inside, not with his friends, stuck with us. And he loves us and we love him, but it's not easy for him. Goes out in the snow and he's with other kids and he's talking to them and seeing them, wearing his mask, of course, and he's having more fun. He's just absolutely can release. And he just loves to go out in the snow. Thank God it snowed. 12 years old. Whew. Vaughn is big, yes. He's almost as tall as I am. He's 5'6". He's taller than both his grandma and his mom. He is a good young man. He is a good young man. Thank you, Michelle. He really is a good kid. Big heart. He's got a lot of wisdom. Carries a lot of wisdom in that young mind. Is a lot of kids do that though. Cheers. Here's a song I wrote. Oh, it's up too high. I'll stop it. Farewell Tits. I wrote this just for Tootsie. That's the omens. That's not it either. Whoops. Accidentally opened Sibelius. That's their opening music. Gotta close Sibelius. But all these things open so easily, they don't care. The computer doesn't care. Open everything! Fine, I can do it. Just open everything. Go ahead. Good. The hell with your audience. Just open them things. Here's a better one to do. I just got to sit and listen for a minute. Green. Joe Cohn, Joe's in there. Nice story. Thank you. Let's turn them over while we can. That's very nice. Listen, folks, it's a perfect way to end. I don't feel like going back and playing the bass. You'll pardon me. I don't feel like it. See, that's with coffee. Jeez. I'm loving. Don't think for a second I'm losing my enthusiasm. Every time I really want to spend more time every day preparing the show. I hope I can only make some money doing this. I would love this. To actually, you know, start at noon and prepare and look for tapes and find things and stuff. And put it together with a computer that now apparently can handle it. Fly Me to the Moon. I'm hooked in the CD too. Thank you, Mary Jane. I appreciate that. It's a good one. I like it. And Benny, I got to talk to Benny because I didn't realize how great he played on this record. Anyway, I'll put another one on just for the fun. Let's see what's a good one. Skylark. Let's try Skylark. And we'll fade out with Skylark. good night to anyone still listening.